Welcome again. So in today's EPANET tutorial, we are going to learn how to perform hydraulic modeling or how to use EPANET software to model this kind of water distribution system. Okay, so before we even proceed, let me show you something. So let me select here at browser, let me select this browser, and for each link, let me select velocities. As you can see, these are the velocities values that we are having. Of course, they are within acceptable range, most of them. And again, if I select here at the unit losses, again, they are within acceptable range. Okay, again, most of them. And not just that, let me close this and let me select up for each node, let me select pressure. And if you can take a closer look, especially at these end junctions here, you can see we are having pressure of this value. So from here, what we are having is 26, here is 31, here is 20, again here is 29. In a simple language, we are having pressure that is somehow not above 3 bars or above 30 meters of water columns. That is very important. So in this EPANET tutorial, I'm going to show you how to optimize your model just to make sure that you are having velocities, pressure, unit head losses within acceptable values. Okay, within acceptable values. Not just that, I'm going to show you how to use brake pressure tanks as a way of dealing with these huge pressures. Okay, so this is our BPT number 3. Again, this is BPT number 2, and this is BPT number 1. So not just that, I'll even show you how to come up with this kind of report, which is very good, especially when you are dealing with, when you want to produce a report for your project. Okay, so if you're new here, my name is Engineer Rodrick, and this is Hydroinformatics Academy, a place where we discuss about how to use hydraulic modeling for smart and informed water decisions. That being said, I'll see you in the next part of this video. Okay, so before we start doing anything, the first thing that we need to do is to make sure that our settings are correct. So to do that, what I can do here is just to go here to project, and I'm going to select defaults. So from here, you as you can see here, we have like 3 tabs. So the first one is ID label, properties, and hydraulics. So for hydraulics, what I need to do is to set my units into metrics. So if you want to use a metric unit, then here is where you can set. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do here is to set our flow units into the units that you want to use. So for me, I'm going to use liters per second. Okay, liters per second. So I'll just pick liters per second from here. So if you want to use empirical units, for example, then you can choose the empirical units like a gallon per minute or the other ones. So for me, I'm just going to use metric units, and for that case, I'm going to select this liters per second here. The next important settings here is head loss formula. Okay, so we have been using Hazen-Williams for quite a long time now. So for this EPANET tutorial, I'm going to use DAS Westpac. Okay, DAS Westpac. Of course, feel free to use Hazen-Williams if you want. So for me, and for this tutorial, I'm going to use DAS Westpac. Okay, so that is done. So the other units from here, I can just leave the way they are. Then I'll just go here to ID label. And again, this one is very important. I want to label my junctions with like junction 1, junction 2, junction 3, or J1, J2, J3. So from here, I'll just select J, then hyphen. And again, for reservoirs, I'll just select R, then hyphen. And for tanks, if I have, so I'll just select ST, which present a storage tank, then hyphen. And again, for links or pipes, I'll just select P, then hyphen. And again, for pumps, I don't have pumps. And again, patterns, I don't even have patterns. So from here, I'll just click OK. Again, this is very important step. I'll just click OK. So you can even set these units as a defaults if you prefer. Okay, so I'll just click OK. So from here, the next step here is to draw our network. Okay, so this is our, so the source, the water source for our network is a river. So I'll just select this reservoir, just to model a river. Okay, so in EPANET, we model a river by using a reservoir. Okay, so I'll just select this reservoir. Then I'll just insert here some few nodes. This one here, and also this one. And again, I'll just insert the other junction from here, and again, the other one here. And again, the other ones are in this region, and the another one also is in this region. And again, we have some few water distribution points. So from here, what we need to do is to insert other junctions in this region. So I'll just add the other ones in this area, and again, in this area, in this area. I hope my space is going to be enough. Okay, so the other one here, the last one, will be located in this area here. Okay, so what I need to do from here is just to link my junctions with a pipe or a link. So for that case, I'll just select here, add pipe. Then I'm going to link these junctions from here. So this, I'll just link them just like this. So I'll just select this one, and I'll link with this. And again, this one, I'll link with this one, and also this one. So from here, just take this one and link with this, and again, link it with this, and again, this one, and this one, and this in this area, I'll just link them the way, just like this. Right, left click, then select, and again, also in this area, and in this area. Okay, left click, and left click in the middle of this junction. So this is a simple network that we are having here. So our network is drawn already. So what we need to do now is to assign elevation data. Okay, elevation data, that is very important. So from here, what we need to do is just to select this. Let me select this one, and let me start assigning elevation data from here. So the total head here is 1400. Okay, let me push it in this area. And again, for this junction here, J1, the total elevation here is 1360. And again, this one here, elevation at this area here is 1330. And again, at this area here, elevation here is 1310. And at this area here, elevation is 1307. And in this region here, elevation is 1280. And for this region here, let me check. I think everything is okay. So let me select this junction again. So let me select here elevation, and assign it is 1300. And for this end junctions here, elevation here is 1280. And again, in this junction, the elevation value here is 1270. So let me select, so for this one and also this one, elevation here is 1280. Let me push it a little bit. And in this area here, elevation is 1270. And in this area here, elevation here is 1250. And again, for this one, elevation is 1245. Okay, 1245. So the next step is to assign pipe length. Okay, so for each link or for each pipe, we need to assign the pipe length. Okay, so from here, so let me start with this pipe here and assign it. Okay, so by default, EPANET is going to assign 1,000 meters as a default value for length. We don't want this. We need to assign our length value. So from here is 263, and again this one here, the length here is 600. And again, this one here, the length is 550. And again, this one also, the length is 600. Okay, 600. And again, this one here, the length is 618. And for this one here, the length here is 260, and this one here, the length is 250. This one, the length is 150, and again, this one here is 200. So let me go to this. So this one done, and let me select this. So the length here is 218, and again, this one here, the length is 250. And again, for this one, the length here is 270, and this one, the length is 150. Okay, so for now, we have done with our pipe length. We need to assign the base demand. Okay, so the base demand. So in this end junction here, and also this one, and this one, and this one, we need to assign the base demand. So in this area here, the base demand here is 1.2. Remember, this is average base demand, 1.2. And again, this one, again, the same value, 1.2. And again, this one here is 1.2. And this one here is 1.2. Remember, this is a loop area. And to assign the demand, we just take the total value demand. So we just take the total value, and then we divide it by the total number of junctions. So the total demand around this area here was 4.8. So we just take that 4.8 and divide it by the total number of junctions in this area here. So let me close this and assign the other demand in this area. So this one here is 0.7, and again, this one here is 0.35. And again, from here, we have another 0.7. Remember, this is in liters per second. And again, this one here is 0.35. And again, this one here is 0.7. Okay, so far, so good. What we need to do here possibly is to add some text. Okay, some text. So let me go here to text and add label. So this one here is a small town. This one here is a small town. And again, this area here, we have a simple distribution point. And again, this one here is another distribution point. Just to keep things simple, I'll just call it a keto trough. A keto trough. And again, let me click enter. And again, this one also is a distribution point or water point. And this one again is a keto trough. Keto trough. And this one here is a primary school. Primary school. So from here, what you need to do is to increase a little bit its font. So let's assume here it is that value. And again, this one, and also this one, we need to do the same. We also need to do the same. And again, at primary school, we need to do the same. And again, this one is our source, which again, we can term it as a river. And again, we'll just do the same. Let me select the value here and increase its font to 11. Okay, so again, for this one, let me increase a little bit its value to 11. So this is the situation that we have. So this is a source, this is a small town. Of course, this is a domestic consumption area. And again, this here is a primary school. This is a keto trough distribution point, and the same applies in this region. Okay, so the demand, we have assigned the demand already, so everything is okay. But remember, we are using this waste pipe. So if I click one pipe in this area, you can see the roughness coefficient here is 100, which is possibly the values of Hazen-Williams. We are not using Hazen-Williams and we are using DAS Westpac. So we need to assign here the roughness coefficients factor, which are relevant to DAS Westpac. So to do that, you can even go here and assign the values by from one link to another. So what I can do is to first identify the pipe material that I am using in my network. So here we are using a GS pipe. Again, this one here is a plastic pipe. Okay, but for this area, again, we are using the GS pipe or steel pipe. Okay, so steel pipe. Again, this one steel pipe, and also this one steel pipe, except this area here, we are using a plastic pipe. So from here, so let me select the DAS Westpac value. So let me select this as simple text. As you can see, for galvanized or cast iron, the DAS Westpac friction factor here is a range within 0.06 to 0.3. So I'll just pick here the average value. So the average value here is 0.18. So I'm just going to use 0.18 in this area to present the GS pipe or steel pipe. And again, for this area here, we are using plastic pipes. So let me go back to my table here. As you can see, for plastic pipes, what we are having here is from 0.02 to 0.05. So I'll just pick the average value from here, or the middle value. So for that matter here, the average value here, or the middle value, will be 0.035. And again, in this area, the average value will be 0.035. And again, this one here, 0.035. And again, here, 0.035. Okay. So we are going to do the same in this area. Again, let me assign 0.035. And again here, 0.035. So to simplify things, what you can do, if for example here we want to use the same material for this one and this one, what you can do is to select a region area. So to select this region here, select region. And then let me pick this region here. So from here, what I need to do is a simple action. So from here, I'll just go to edit and select a group edit. So in this area here, I want to assign the pipes with a roughness coefficient of, remember here we are using a steel pipes or GS pipes. I'll just select here the value of 0.18. Okay, then I'll click OK. Okay, so two pipes were updated. So this one and this one, if I'm not mistaken. So let me check the again. And this one, as you can see, these are the value. Okay, so for this region here, let's assume we are using plastic. So let me select again the region and select from here to here. And then I'll left click just to join this and this. So let me select a group edit from here, edit, then group edit, and then I'm going to assign, if so for all pipes, so for all pipes I'm going to assign the roughness coefficients to 0.035. okay, it seems as though this pipe here P10 is not, so I'll just assign manually. And again, for this area, again, let's assume we are using a plastic pipe. So let me select here 0.035. So for now, our roughness coefficients are well set. What we need to do? So what we need to do from here is to run our model. At least let's see what we are getting. Okay.